It's absolutely fantastic to have you here with us at Showmasters. You've been enjoying yourself so far this weekend?
Yes. I was very sick yesterday and I didn't even make it. I got off the plane and was ill, so I didn't have a good day yesterday, but today is made up for it all. So I'm having a wonderful time.
Fans do get to meet you. What are the most common questions you get asked?
Can you stick a blender in my head and kill me? I know, you wouldn't think that's common, but I've had a few of them. What else? A lot of home and away questions still, which actually is pretty amazing because I haven't been on the show for 10 years. So it's amazing that people still remember like me from that show and from that role. And I didn't realize that home and away was so popular over here. You know, I knew it was popular, but I didn't know it was so popular. So it's been really nice meeting all the fans and to see what they've come out exactly for, because some people will know me as Cassie from home and away, and some want the, you know, Disney step up thing and then the horror thing. So it's been really cool, and I love these conventions. They're the time of your life, you know. They're for the fans.
Starting with the horror thing, obviously you're next, a big hit, and working with your flatmate, I believe. So can you tell us a little bit about that experience?
Yeah, it was the best experience of my life, you know. I mean, shooting the movie, it would not have been the same without having her there. It was really special because, yeah, we were living together in LA for 5 years, and then, you know, we both booked this movie and we both basically just pack up our life and move ourselves over to middle America and become vampires and live this night schedule. And it was just very ironic that in the end, like, you know, I have to kill her. And you know, I always said that it would be pretty cool to like kill your best friend in a movie, but you know, it was actually so much fun. Like, we had a ball. It was too much fun. And people get quite shocked to find out that, you know, we're really good friends off screen, because I think you just know what you know on screen, and she's the best. So it was a pleasure.
Of course, so many horror fans all around the world. What do you think people get from that genre that they perhaps don't from other types of cinema?
I always thought that the horror genre for me growing up, and I was really like addicted to it as a kid, and I think it's something about being like taken out of body and being scared. It's strange to think that as humans we voluntarily sort of nominate ourselves for like being really scared. We just want to have that experience. And you know, I think that's why I always just liked watching horror movies, and I never had nightmares. I never really suffered any of that. I just really enjoyed just having that feeling that only a horror movie can really give you. And it's just funny that now, later in life, that's where I'm sort of headed into the horror world, because I was obsessed with horror movies growing up, so it's actually quite cool for me.
Also, at the other end of the spectrum, you mentioned people know you, of course, from the Step Up franchise.
Yeah.
What did it mean for you to be a part of that, and can you just talk about that experience?
Oh, it meant everything. I'm a third generation performer and dancer in my family, and my grandma really kicked it off, and then my mum was musical theatre, and everybody in my family has caught the entertainment bug. So, you know, I think I danced for like 18 years or something before I booked Home and Away, and then I loved working on Home and Away, but the one thing that it took away from me was that passion for dancing and for performing. So to be able to bring that back and sort of showcase, you know, my dance abilities into a role like Step Up was just absolutely a dream come true. And, you know, my grandma passed away a while ago, but the movie I dedicated to her, because without, you know, her talents, then it wouldn't have all been passed through. So it was everything to me, that film. And the fact that I knew already about it, with its successful dance franchise, if not the most successful dance franchise, and it's to pick an Aussie girl that just literally had stepped off the plane from Australia and landed in LA and just got a visa. And, you know, there's so many other people that would have done such an amazing job at that role. So I just feel really lucky to have been the one that they picked to get to do that, you know.
What's coming up next for you? Where are we going to see you next?
Actually, just got back from China, shooting a movie with Jackie Chan. It's called Dragon Blade. Comes out in February, first day of the Chinese New Year next year. And so that was very cool. I got to work with John Cusack and Adrian Brody and Jackie Chan, who's been an idol of mine for such a long time. I didn't get to utilize the martial arts, which is what I really, really want to go towards. So hopefully in the next film, I'm going to put it out there, that I get to do with Jackie Chan, I'll get to, like, you know, do a lot more action stuff. And that's where I want to head, is really into that sort of martial arts action world, and following someone like that's footsteps would just be out of control. So it was a real pleasure to have the experience to work with him.
Jackie's an absolute icon. Can you talk about what he's like in real life, though?
Yeah, well, that was actually the most incredible part for me, because I just know him as the icon that is Jackie Chan, but actually the person behind, like, the image as well is, like, it floored me. He is so incredible and devoted to all his charities. If he's not working and if he's not on set shooting, then he's traveling and he's just giving back. And he does it with his own cash. He does it on his own time. And it's the most important thing to him is to give back. And if he's not shooting, then that's all he's doing is traveling for his charities. And he played me a video, actually, we were at dinner, and he played me a video that he'd shot, that's all different edits of all the different works that he's done around the world. And it was just the most breathtaking video to see the impact that he's having on all these kids, and, you know, to encouraging them to live their dreams. And I mean, it's just fantastic. It really truly is. So if possible, and it is possible, he's actually more of a legend in real life than he is as what you know of just Jackie Chan, which just says a lot.
My final question, have you got a message for fans watching this all around the world? Anything you'd like to say to them?
I love you.